Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about different locators available in Selenium. First, let us understand what are locators. Let me open a website. So stackoverflow.com is a website, right? So you can see different fields here. So you can see some three lines here. This Stack Overflow is an image about products. These are the links, and we have a search text box. You can see the buttons here, login, sign up. These are the buttons. So these are the different fields. And we actually provide some input on this. Our user performs some action on these fields so that we get some result. For example, on a text box, we provide some input, right? On a button, we actually perform some action called click. So these are all the user actions, right? And each field is called as a web element here. And now we wanted to mimic these user actions using the web driver. And how does web driver interact with these web elements is, so web driver needs to know the location of this web element. So we can have multiple different elements on a web page. So this is the web page, complete web page. And you can see, right? So there are multiple different web elements on this web page alone. And web driver needs to know which element, which web element it needs to interact with, and what's the action it needs to perform on that particular web element. And how does web element do this is, so web driver needs to know the exact location of the web element. So each web element on this web page has a specific location, and web driver needs to know that location of the particular web element to interact with. And to find this location, we have different locators in Selenium. So that's what we call as different locators, right? Now, before actually looking into what are the different locators available in Selenium, let us understand some basics of HTML. So behind each web element, right? So there's a HTML code. Right click here and just say inspect. So you can see here, right? This elements console, all this, right? So just click on this elements tab. This is called as a dev tools. You also get this by clicking function F12 on your machine. So this is called dev tools, right? And on the first tab, click on the first tab elements, and you can see the HTML code. Don't worry, you don't need to learn the complete HTML language, but we just need to know the ABCs of HTML. So you can see this is the code which is driving this web page. And you can see, right, the first tag will be HTML. So here, the HTML code's language, we call each one as a tag. So you can see HTML is one tag here. So it starts with greater than symbol, tag. So each tag has a different meaning. So HTML. And then you can see the different attributes here. So within, once the tag is started, so we'll be having different attributes. And attribute is a key value pair. So class is a key, and whatever the value within this double quotes is a value. So this is what we need to know. And once all the attributes are done within the tag, right? Say for example, this tag, header tag, right? So header tag again has some child view, and it has some attributes. Class is one attribute, role is one attribute, like this. Finally, this tags will end with /div, right? For this div, this is the end tag. So each tag will have the end tag. Again, the end tag will also be enclosed within the less than, greater than, and less than symbols, right? So each one has a tag, and each tag has some meaning within it. And each tag, within each tag, we have some attributes, and each attribute is a key value pair. So this is what we need to know at a minimum. And if you observe, so you can just see here a mouse cursor symbol, right? So just click on that and hover over on any web element available here. So I'm hovering on this text box. You can see here. So when we hover on this text box, the highlighted part here in this dev tools, in this elements tab, right? So in blue, you can see something highlighted. So this is the exact location of this web element called text box. So once we have this location, so you can see the highlighted part, right? So this is the location of the web element. And we use this location to actually find that web element on this web page. And we are going to actually use this particular highlighted part using the web driver. So we actually provide some input from this highlighted part to the web driver so that it actually finds the exact location of the web element. Once we find the web element location, then we can actually do the second part of performing an action on that web element. All right, now we are good to go to the know and learn the different locators in Selenium. So let's actually start looking at what are all the different locators available in Selenium. So the first one is ID. Using ID, we can actually find the web element, right? And remember, whatever element we find, web element we find using the locators, that has to be unique. So meaning if we find an element on the web element using the locators, so the address should be unique. The location should be unique so that the web driver will not have, you know, any ambiguity or confusion to exactly locate the web element. So it has to be uniquely identifiable. So ID is one locator. Name, we can actually use name to locate the web elements. Class name, tag name. CSS selector is another locator. And within CSS selector, we have again four different types using tag and ID, using tag and attribute, tag and class, tag, class, and attribute. And link text is one locator. We have partial link text. And finally, we have XPath, one of the important locators. So these are the different locators available in Selenium. Now, let us understand these locators, each of these locators with an example. So let me create a class. I'll call my class as locators. And let me take the code of, you know, instantiating the web driver, maximizing the window, all this from the previous example. This we saw in the previous videos, right? So this actually launches our Chrome browser and maximizes the browser window. All right. Now, what are we going to do? We are going to navigate to a website and we are going to find the web elements on that and perform some actions on that web page. Right? So get, we know it actually navigates to a particular website. So what, where are we going to navigate is Stack Overflow. So this is the website we'll be navigating. And what are the action we are going to perform? So let's see. I wanted to click on this login. Right? So let's take till here so that we'll directly navigate onto this web page, login page, right? First, we'll navigate to this web page so that we are into this page where we can actually provide the email and password. So I wanted to provide input as techstack9@gmail.com is my email ID. And I wanted to provide this input in a field called email. So, and then I'll provide my password here. And then I wanted to click on this login. So you can see login button here, right? So I wanted to click on this login button. So this is what we wanted to automate now. So let's do it step by step now. So the first part, what we wanted to do is we wanted to provide the input into the email text box. So how do we do that is again, so just press function F12 so that DevTools is popped up. Select the elements tab. You see the cursor part here, right? So cursor image, just click on that, hover over on the web element, any web element. Now we wanted to find the location of the web element called email. Email is a text box field, you can see here. So I just hover on this email text box. So you can see the highlighted part here. So this is the location of that web element email. Now we need to choose some locator here. And the first locator, if you see here, is ID. Now let's actually find out the locator of the email web element using ID. So what is ID here? So we just now discussed, right? So input is a tag here. These are the different attributes. Class is one attribute, ID, type, size, max, length, name, all are the different attributes within this input tag. Now we wanted to actually locate this web element using ID. ID is one of the locators available in Selenium, right? So you can see ID, and what's the value of ID? It's email. So we need to copy this exact value, email. As we wanted to find this location of this email web element using ID. And remember, in the complete this web page, so there should not be any other web element which will have the same ID email. So it has to be unique. Only then WebDriver will not have any ambiguity, and it can directly find or locate this web element called email. Now we know how to actually, what's the ID of that web element email, right? So, and now how are we going to tell that to the our WebDriver? So for that, we have a method called find element. Driver is our WebDriver object. Find element is a method which actually takes the object of by class. By is a class, you can see, dot. So it has some methods within it. So by dot, we wanted to actually find it by ID. So you can see ID. Again, ID method takes string value. So we just now copied it as email, right? So this is the value of ID attribute. So I just put that here. So this actually makes the web driver know the exact location of the email web element. So what did we do here is driver find element is a method, and we need to provide the parameter of by object. So by is a class dot, it has some methods within it. So we are using ID as we wanted to find email web element using the ID locator. And how did we get this email? So if you go back, you can see the different attributes within this input tag, and we have chosen ID. So value of this ID. And that's what I have put here. Now, WebDriver is able to locate the element, web element email, fine. Now, if you observe, we wanted to perform some action. That is, we wanted to provide some input to this, that field, fine. So if you observe, this find element is actually returning web element object, right? Now, web element, I wanted to capture that. Web element, this is the email, right? So I'll name it as email, email object. Just import this web element from org.openqa.selenium package. Now we have an email object, which is a web element, and which is the address of the email field, right? Fine. WebDriver is able to locate it now. And we have that web element in an object called email. And now we wanted to perform some action on that object. What's the action we wanted to perform? We wanted to provide some input into it. And how can we do that is web element object dot send keys is a method which actually takes char sequence, character array sequence. So whatever you provide here, that will be actually provided into the web element identified by this email object. Email is an object of text field. So it will actually write whatever you put it here as a char sequence. Now I am going to provide my email ID. Now till here, let us execute the program and verify. And we can see it navigates to the Stack Overflow login page, and it actually, you can see, I didn't enter that. So it was automatically provided by the WebDriver. WebDriver was successfully able to identify the email field, and it was able to provide the input as well, whatever input we gave it, right? So you can see that here, right? Now, the second part, we wanted to provide password as well. And for that, let's again go back and find the second locator in Selenium is by name, right? So let's actually locate password field. Now the highlighted part is the location of the web element called password. And now we wanted to actually see an example on name locator. So let's choose name here, and the value is password here. So the same part, find element is a method. We need to provide a parameter as a by object, by dot. This time we wanted to choose name as the method, and password is the value of name attribute. So I'm just providing password here. And again, we wanted to perform some action, that is, we wanted to provide our password. And so I'm going to capture that into the web element. I'm going to call that as pass. And then pass dot, we wanted to provide some input into it, character sequence. So I'm going to provide my password here. Now let's verify again. And you can see now, see, it has provided the email and it also provided the input as password. Now we wanted to click on this login. So let's see that now. So let me go back to the locators. Now we wanted to see an example on class name. Let's see an example on class name. And for that, let's go back. Now we wanted to click on login button, right? So let's hover on this login button. This is the address of the login button, and we wanted to have the class name. So if you see, button is the tag, and you can see the it ends with button, and you can see the different attributes here, class, ID, name. We can choose any of these attributes, but we wanted to see an example on class name. So let's choose class name here. And we don't need to capture anything here. We just wanted to click on that web element, right? So find element by dot. We wanted to see an example on class name. So I'll provide class name here. And what's the value of it? So I copied it. So this is the value of it. We can actually capture this, whatever find element is written is web element. So we can capture it, and then we can actually perform the action on the button. But as we wanted to perform some action that we already know, right? We wanted to actually click on that button. So we can actually directly write it here, like dot click is a method which actually clicks on the web element. So here the web element here is the button, right? So we actually found the element which is a button, and we are using the method called click, which actually clicks on the button. So this is the login button. Let me put it here. Now let me execute the program. And now you can see, right? So it actually stopped. And let's see what happened. So we can see an error here. It says exception, invalid selector exception. So you can see the exception here, compound class names not permitted. So WebDriver not able to identify the login button. So what happened here is, you can see the class name value here. So it has some spaces in it. So then WebDriver considers it as different classes. And if it has different classes, WebDriver can't actually identify the exact class web element using the class name. That's the reason it says there are multiple classes or there are compound classes, so which are not permitted is what the error says here, right? So on this particular web page, there is no other class name which can uniquely identify the any web element. So for that, what we'll do is we'll take another example. In order to show you how class name works or how we can locate an element using the class name, we'll see another example. So airbnb.co.in is a website where we can actually, this is a website where we can use this to book the flight tickets and guest rooms and whatnot, right? So we'll navigate to this website. Then we wanted to click on this location web element, and then we'll actually provide some text here, and then we'll hit enter. this is what we wanted to perform on this website. So let's create an example, new example or new class here. I'll call this as class locator. Let me quickly copy the three lines, the first four lines. And we wanted to navigate to this website this time, airbnb.co.in. So let me navigate to this website. And then we wanted to locate this location. So again, function F12 and inspect this location. So initially we will not have this value. It will be like this, right? So locate this element. You can see the location of this web element. And you can see the input tag here and class, you can see a value here, right? So let's take this value and find that element. Find element by dot, class name is a method, and this is the value. And let's capture this into a web element object. Web element or a location. And just import this web element from Selenium package. Location dot, we wanted to provide some input into it. So let's provide some input into it. And send keys is an array of char sequence, right? So we can provide multiple values into it so that all these will be provided from left to right into that input field or text field. So Goa, and then we wanted to hit enter. So for that, we can actually use keys class. There's a class called keys dot. There are some enum values in it. So we can select enter. So that what happens is, so location is a web element. Into that, we are providing input as Goa. And then once we provide Goa, then enter will be pressed. Now let me execute this program. You can see here, the main focus should be on the class name. So we wanted to understand class name locator here. And you can see here, so it entered Goa, right? And also hit enter, right? So this is the example on class name. Now, let's actually go back to the next locator, tag name. So let me close this now, and you can see the again, I'm back to the Stack Overflow website. So we provided the email ID, provided the password. We wanted to click on login, but it didn't work with the class name. So we actually saw a different example on the class name. Fine. Now we wanted to actually verify the tag name. So if you have see here, button is a tag. And we wanted to see an example on the tag name. But if you see here, there are many other buttons as well. Login, sign up, other buttons. So we can't actually go with the button to identify the login button, as there are multiple buttons on this web page. So again, if we have multiple elements on the same web page, so we can't actually identify with this tag name, as this tag name will be there for other web elements as well. So in that case, how will this tag name will be handy is, so in such cases, what we can do is, we can actually use a tag name to actually find something like all the links on the web page. For example, all these are the links about products for teams. So a link is simple. When you click on that, it actually takes you or navigates you to a different web page, is what we call it as a link. All these links, right? These are all called as links. So let's actually hover over any of them. So I just clicked on the about. You can see here the web element location of about. And it starts with the tag A, which meaning anchor. So this we call it as an anchor tag. Right, and you can see here about is the value of this anchor tag. That is, this is a link. Again, when I hover over on the product, it also has anchor tag A, right? So all the links will be having the tag as A, anchor. So the tag A represents anchor, right? So now what we'll do is on this web page, what are all the links we have? That we'll actually find it out using the tag called A, right? So let's do that now. Let's go back to locators. Let me comment this out as this was not working. Now, what we are going to do, we are going to find the using WebDriver object. There is a method called find elements. So if there is more than one object match, more than one web element matches with whatever method we wanted to identify the web elements, if there is more than one element identifies, then we can actually capture all those elements using the method find elements. Just observe here, still now we used find element, which actually returns only one web element. But here we know prior that there will be more than one web element matches with whatever we are going to provide now, right? So we use find elements to capture all the web elements that matches with this location or with this locator by dot tag name. I'll provide just A. A is my tag name. So whatever the web element which has the tag as A, all those web elements, I wanted to capture it now. So you can see here, find elements, I am using find elements here, and this find elements is actually returning list of web elements. So earlier find element was returning only web element, as we will be getting one web element. But this find elements will actually return multiple web elements, which actually will have the tag name as A. Right, so we need to capture that into the list of web elements. So let's capture that into the list of web elements. Just import list from java.util package, and let's call this as, I'll just call this as links. Okay. Now what we'll do is we'll just print something like total links or total tags with anchor, or we'll just say total anchor tags. We'll find the, as it is a list, right? So we can just use the size method to print the size of the tags on that web page. And also what we can do is if we wanted to actually look into all the links, then for each web element of list of web elements, we can just print link here so that we can actually look into all the links on that web page. So this is how we can actually use the tag name. I just executed. Now we can see. Yeah, this we didn't comment it out, so it just provides the input and then it actually stops. And you can see different these are the different anchor tags which are available. So, but you can see it actually says it is coming from the Chrome driver. Okay, the issue here was we actually trying to print the link as is. So link is a web element, so we are getting the web element address, but we wanted to get the text of the link. So for that, we can use link.getText. We'll actually give the exact text of the link. So we need to use the getText method on the web element. Now let's execute again. Now you can see the all links on this web page. You can see the text here. So earlier we didn't actually provide this getText method, so we just got the web elements displayed here. But this time we wanted to get the text of the links. So you can see Stack Overflow, about, products, for teams. So we saw all this, right? These are all the links, which are all available on this web page. So you can see the count as well. So there are like 42 links on this web page, and we can see all the links on this web page, right? So you can see some are hidden here, hidden web elements. So this is how we can actually use the tag name locator to locate multiple elements on the web page. And in the next video, we'll discuss about other locators. Thanks for watching.